chaos. The Star Wars fan community has once again been torn apart with the release of The Rise of Skywalker. Despite The Mandalorian's best efforts, the release of the most recent film has stoked the flames of conflict within the fan base that originate with Rian Johnson's The Last Jedi. However, with the return of the Clone Wars on Disney Plus, one man hopes that the community will once again unite for the good of the franchise. As such, he purchased one figure to review to celebrate its return and to get others excited for the stellar series' return from the ashes.
Hello everybody, my name is Kanohii Manika and welcome back to the Toy Review. Today we have not something as special as the last Toy Review, but a character who is special in my heart and in probably many others. Here we have the Black Series version of Best Clone, Captain Rex. Now I was hoping to review this figure back when Clone Wars was actually airing again, you know, over the past couple of months. However, I was extremely lazy with the Iron Man review, and I didn't want this review to come first, so things came to, and I did not review him in time. Of course, I'm so lazy. But yeah, now we're finally getting around to his review, which will probably be a lot shorter than the last Iron Man-a-thon, but hey, it's okay. To start off, as per usual, I really like the paint and the sculpt on this figure. It's a lot more detailed than your typical Hasbro figure, in all honesty, you know? I don't know why. Maybe it's because it started off as a con exclusive before being released to the public. I don't know. I'm pretty sure the con exclusive has somewhat better painting. However, even compared to other Black Series figures that I have, this is a lot better, you know? Especially, we'll get to it. We'll get to that. We'll get to it. Once again, there is a level of non-consistency in the textures of stuff, but that's good because the different parts of his armor and clothing shouldn't have the same texture. So like all of the under clothes, which you can see like here, they are rendered, well, they are made of the same block of plastic. However, they've been painted with a nice matte black style paint, which allows it to have a lot more of a rough texture compared to the armor plastic here, which has a nice white glossy sheen to it, which I would expect from any clone trooper or any white armored Star Wars soldier, you know? I want to start with a look at the head sculpt. However, this helmet is not the head sculpt. It's technically an accessory, and we'll get to it, but the helmet, as with lots of good clone trooper figures, is removable, allowing for us to see, if I am able to pan up here, a really nice photo real tech based Temuera Morrison head, which makes sense because he is a clone trooper, and since the Black Series goes for a more realistic style, it makes sense that they would give him the Temuera Morrison head, though I feel a bit more nostalgic for the, the Clone Wars styled head, which I have a Rex figure in that style, which I will show off later on. Sadly, one problem with the helmet is that it sort of flattens the nose a bit, if that makes sense, because, like, the helmet has a little bit too little room for the head sculpt, so the nose sort of gets flattened a bit, which is annoying. However, I can't be complaining too much since it hasn't really damaged the face paint, so it's okay. It's fine. It's just an issue with some of the sculpting on the figure. Alongside that, I also really like how they rendered his hair sculpt, with it being the white kind of like buzz cut style, though he does have a little bit more hair than I originally thought, but it's still really well done, especially for trying to give realism to a character from a cartoon series, you know? Which they also did with Ahsoka, and if you're seeing this for the Black Series vote fan vote thingy, please vote for Ahsoka to get reissued. Please. So that I can review that figure. Who cares about that tangent? Putting the helmet back on, Captain Rex, it does seem a tiny bit big to me. I don't know. I don't know what it is. It just seems a tiny bit big for the torso. However, that's really my only complaint, and that's probably a product of it having to slip onto the head. The head would be too small, or the helmet would be too big. Whatever. Or they would be the right size, but the helmet would be too thin of a material to be really high on the safety standards or whatever. But whatever. Other than that, and the fact that I think the isolate's a bit small, I love this helmet. It very much renders the way that Rex's helmet works in the show. I'm gonna slowly spin it around here for you. It has a lot of great detail, including the hash marks on the head, which is presumably a kill count, which seems a bit small as we look at the other ones as well. But whatever, maybe you didn't have time to put them all on. And something you'll notice, you might not be able to notice it, but if you can notice it, there's a lot of just like slight bits of weathering throughout the helmet, which will be seen throughout the rest of the figure. But it's kind of like a black wash, if that makes sense. It's kind of like they meticulously put a lot of this figure through a black wash. I'm not saying that all of it went through a black wash. Some of it is obviously just like digital painting, like Hasbro likes to do on their figures, probably as a cost-saving measure. But in all honesty, some of it looks just really nice and like comparable to that of a black wash, you know, or a brown wash or whatever. And I also really like how they rendered these, which are a very, I forget their name, but they're a very iconic part of Captain Rex's look, you know? So it's important that they were there and rendered in a very nice way. I also like how they kept the uniqueness of the helmet, as it is meant to be him fusing his Phase 1 helmet to a typical Phase 2 helmet, you know? So I like how they kept that and also had the welding detail that a lot of other designs have, though I feel a bit weird with all the orange on it. That's just a problem I have with certain versions of this, is it seems a bit heavy-handed, in my opinion, but it's fine. Other figures do this as well, including like the minifigure and a lot of other figures do this level of orange on it, though it's probably just like exemplify that it was welded together. But I do really like the silver detail where it is welded together, I'll be honest. Moving on to the body of the figure, his pauldron is in a slightly rubbery plastic, which makes sense, you know. I would assume that it would be a flexible material in universe, you know? And also, it seems to be removable for anyone who wants to do any sort of custom, like ARC Trooper, like maybe if you want to do like a Captain Fordo or something like that, in theory, you could just take this, remove it, repaint the blue bits red, and then give it to like a Phase 1 Trooper alongside the cloth bits at the bottom, which we'll get to as well. But yeah, outside of the. Of course, there's this little bandolier bit, which I also really like. Going down to lower on the body, you can see how it's very nicely separated, which the articulation takes advantage of the way that the armor is separated in a very good way that allows it to stay natural while still making the most of the articulation that you can have on an armored figure like this. So I really like it. I really like how it's done, and some more of the welding detail is seen here as well, you know? Which is still really nice, and otherwise it's very similar to other Clone Trooper figures that have been released by Hasbro. Going to the back of the body armor, same thing goes here. However, also, I really want to bring up the belt a bit. while we're here on the back, I really like how they continued the weathering here on the back of the belt, especially. It looks really nice, in my opinion, at least. You know, the slight dirty look, making him look like he's already been through battle, which he already has since this is his phase two armor. The arm sculpts continue a lot of the same stuff that I've been saying, so I'm not gonna dwell too much on them, except I really like this nice blue streak. It's really nice. I really like the blue that they chose for this, which they've honestly probably used for other 501st characters. I don't know. It would make sense. But also, once again, nice weathering, nice sculpting. The hand does seem a bit painted. Like, the painted white seems a bit off from the sculpted white, but whatever. It's okay. It's okay. Now, to move on to the legs, of course, he has his holsters for his blasters, which right now I have him holding, which we'll get to those in the accessories section. And those are also have the same level of weathering as the belt as well. And then getting around to the waist cape or whatever, I don't know, whatever it's called, pauldron, waist cape, I don't know. Tell me what it is in the comments below, because I'm not a military man or whatever, or a Star Wars military man. I just see things and I think that they look cool. And I think that this looks cool. I really like how they have the blue done here, though I kind of wish it was more woven in, but whatever. However, I also really like that these are made of cloth. That allows them to get in the way minimally when you're articulating it. And for a cape, it can be a bit annoying to have a cloth. However, these are able to fit formally around the legs, you know? And I just think it was just the right choice. And then for the leg sculpting, a lot of the same from last time. I really like how they have these little details, like the hash marks. But yeah, as I said, a lot of the same as goes for the armor, goes with these legs, which makes sense since it's a unified Republic style armor, you know? Just a lot of the same kind of look. Now, I could make a funny joke being like, haha, what isn't the same as his articulation? But we're gonna get to the accessories right now. As previously mentioned, his helmet is an accessory. However, he also has his twin DC-17 blasters, which any Captain Rex figure, he just needs them. He just needs them, you know? And because these are just so iconically Rex at this point, you know? I'm just gonna show one here for now to get the good detail in. Yeah, like as I was saying, these are so iconically Rex that if you're gonna have a Rex figure, you just need these things, you know? These are his iconic weapons. And yes, I know this isn't the SCCC version, which comes with like two other blasters, a long left rifle and a short rifle, but this is really all you need. However, if you want those blasters, you can probably get the Commander Fox figure. He has the whole loadout. However, he isn't as good as this figure, from what I've seen from reviews and promotional pics at least. And if you want to put one of these rifles in his hand, you just kind of just push it in there, you know? Like, you just kind of have it so that the hands, because the hands are slightly more pliable material than a lot of the rest of the figure, so you're able to just kind of wrap the fingers around it. And this hand works the best as it was obviously sculpted to be for the rifle. However, since he's a dual wielding, I kind of wish that the other hand had the same level of sculpting. Instead, they just had like a normal grabby hand, you know? But yeah. It's okay though. He's still able to wield his rifles in some decently cool poses, which this is not a decently cool pose. I'm just really lazy. Speaking of posability, let's get around to that, why don't we? Starting with the head sculpt, it's on a typical Marvel Legends Hasbro style ball joint with a hinge, which with the helmet, it gets less articulation. It's really only able to go up and down and swivel around. However, if you take off the helmet, there's a tiny bit of tilt, you know? However, it's up about that far without the helmet and down about that far without the helmet. And if we bring the helmet and slide it back onto his head, it's down about that far and up about that far, which you're gonna probably be posing him with the helmet because he's Captain Rex during the Clone Wars. You're gonna have him wearing his helmet. Now, I personally feel my favorite part of articulation on this figure is his arms. Now, to show you what I mean, I want to bring in a figure that technically came out later than Captain Rex, you know? I'm going to bring out 2019 Marvel, not Marvel Legends, Star Wars Black Series figure, the Sith Trooper. And I know these guys are kind of hard to compare, but I really like how his shoulder pauldrons specifically are done, at least personally. Now, for the Sith Trooper, who isn't the one that I like how the shoulder pauldrons are done, they're kind of made of a rubbery material, which allows them to go up, you know, as you can see. However, that if you leave it in a pose like this, it'll warp the slightly rubbery plastic. And it's even harder on this side with this little thing, which this is probably the only reason why they didn't do what they did with Rex for this figure, but still, I think this is a annoying way to do it. However, Rex has a much better way of doing it, which he fell sadly, which we'll get to the feet later. The way that his shoulder pauldron, shoulder armor works, which I'm gonna show it on the side with the out a pauldron, you know, is they basically just fold into the armor, you know? As you can see back here, it's just kind of going into his chest armor, which allows it to have a nice, about 90 degrees upward range of articulation without having to worry about, like, sculpt degradation or anything. And sorry, moving back to the head for a second, his aim reticle does fold down, which is nice for anyone who has an aiming reticle. I'm not even sure if their Boba Fett figures do that, but I don't have one of their Boba Fett figures show. So now this figure has another one up on some of the other clone troopers that came before, and a couple of them that came after it, which includes Captain Fox, which is why I might not pick up Captain Fox, is that he has a much higher amount of benditude in his arms, where essentially what they did is add a little cut in the armor on the upper arm, which allows for the double bend in this arm to have a lot more range compared to what old ones had, where since they didn't have the cut, it just kind of stopped at about 90 degrees, you know? However, for this one, he's able to go a lot higher, which allows him to look like he's just kind of bending his arm naturally, about to shoot someone. His arms also have a bicep swivel, and then the hands, they both have a swivel. However, the trigger finger hand is able to go up, if I can make it look good, is able to go up and down, while the non-trigger finger hand goes like for side to side, though it's more downward. It's more inward than outward, honestly, and that's a bit annoying, but you know, whatever. Moving on to the torso, as previously stated, he's able to take advantage of the way that his armor is designed by basically just putting a ball joint in the chest, you know, which allows for him to have a nice crunch, an arcing back, and a faux waist swivel, which is really nice. The legs are probably the most disappointing bit of articulation on the figure. However, they've still got some really nice ways of doing things. Now, his legs are able to kick up forward a little bit, back a little bit, and are able to split, not 100%, but enough. Because I'm not gonna have Captain Rex doing crazy acrobatic tricks. I might have him, like, standing in place and shooting or just running around. Now, for the bend in the knees, it's a nice double bend as seen with the arms, which is able to get about that range. It's not 100%, but whatever, it's close enough. But the most annoying bit of articulation is the feet. Now, it goes with the typical Marvel Legends Black Series style, where you have a rocker pivot, if we get in close here, where you have a rocker pivot as well as a hinge. However, with the way that it's sculpted, it's not able to hinge back very far. And I've found that kind of makes posing a bit more difficult and leads to him sometimes, when doing A poses like this, also slightly leaning forward, which is a bit annoying. Well, let me get down a bit to show you that, at least in my eyes, he seems to be slightly leaning forward. Is that just me? But yeah, it looks like he's slightly leaning forward, at least in my opinion. I don't know. I don't know. He may not have the best articulation out of all the figures that I've reviewed, but I wasn't really expecting that. I just really wanted a really nice Rex figure, and he might be outclassed by that Hot Toys figure that's coming out in, like, a year. Oh, God, I might be making a bad financial decision with that. Oh, no. There are some iconic poses he isn't able to 100% pull off. However, like, for this pose, I should say, some butterfly joints would have come in handy. However, most poses that you want to put a trooper like this into, he can pull off. With some poses that I really like him being in, including shooting poses like this, even though I'm not the best poser in the world, I'm sure you'll find people who are able to take advantage of his poseability way more than I can. And to finish off this review, chunk review, whatever, we are going to do size comparisons, as per usual. Now, to measure him out, Captain Rex stands at about 6 and a little over 6 and 3 quarter, about a little under 6 and 3 quarter inches, I'm going to say. And to compare him with some other characters, we've obviously got to start with the Sith Trooper, because he was already here. I already showed him off. What the heck, guys? Like, the Marvel Legends Build-A-Figure Super Skrull without all of his super-duper bits. Another clone brethren of his, the LEGO Star Wars Buildable Figure Boba Fett. Here he is with Transformers Siege Voyager Class Starscream. Here he is with the Marvel Legends Spider-Man Far From Home Spider-Man. The Transformers Generations Power of the Primes Leader Class Optimal Optimus. Here he is with last week's review, the amazing Yamaguchi Bleeding Edge Iron Man. And finally, here he is with a couple of figures of my childhood, my 3 3/4 inch Captain Rex and Captain Fordo. These are some of my favorite clones of all time, and as I previously mentioned, I wanted to show you this head sculpt, which is very cartoon accurate, and I really like it. But, yeah. This kind of feels weird because, man, Star Wars has changed since I got these figures. We have a whole 5 other movies. And a varying quality, obviously. And I feel like the way the fandom has worked has changed as well, because everyone got just extremely angry and negative around the sequel films. I know how words work. But everyone got extremely negative around the sequel films and started praising the prequels, which they're fine movies. They're fine movies. Clone Wars is the best prequel stuff, though. Nobody would like the prequels if it wasn't for the Clone Wars existing. I'm gonna be honest. If Clone Wars didn't exist, there would be nothing of worth in that era. However, there's so much good concept art in that era, and so many good ideas that were just thrown away, so it's good that someone was able to come back and elaborate on them and make them more memorable and just more favored in the eyes of the community. And in my honest opinion, I think something will happen like that with the sequels, you know? And hey, even if you like the sequels or if you don't like the sequels, whichever opinion that you hold, I'm not angry at you. I don't think anyone should be angry at anyone for an opinion. I know this is getting oddly weird and not political, but like very tangential. Like, because I'm just here to review a figure of a character that I really like. However, I feel like Clone Wars shows that anything in the Star Wars community can be beloved. So just find what you like, I guess, in a time period, rather than focusing on what you truly hate. And if you truly hate something, then just ignore it, I guess. Don't watch it. If you prefer the old Legends continuity, then go on ahead. Make that what you follow for Star Wars, you know? If you like the new continuity better, then sure, because as proven with the prequels, there's gonna be people who grow up with these new films and love them. So you can hold your opinion, just don't get angry at other people for holding theirs. That's just not a good way of doing things. I'm gonna be honest. But this got oddly sad for a video review of an action figure of a prequel character. So, let's just get to the final verdict, I guess. All in all, like with the prequels, there's some blemishes that are in this figure. Some of the articulation isn't great. I wish he came with a second gun hand, because he has two guns. What the hell, Hasbro? And the helmet does flatten his nose. However, as with the Clone Wars, even with those flaws, they were able to take something and make it look amazing and feel amazing and make a great figure out of it. So, hell yeah, I recommend this figure. Why wouldn't I? This is a character that I love, a figure that I think is really good, of a character that I love from a universe that I'm a huge fan of. If you are into Rex as much as I am, pick him up. And even if you aren't into Rex as much as I am, and you just want to like a Star Wars character or like a clone trooper, this is probably your best bet because he's an iconic, a really nice iconic character. You know, he's not just like a random, like just the random guy who killed like Aayla Secura or whatever. But he's like an actual interesting character, and he's a, and still he's a good figure to boot. So if you can find him for about retail price, or even just like $10 above retail price, I feel like he's worth it, especially with the level of paint and detail that they put into this figure, the amount of love they put into this figure. So yeah, I guess that's the review for this week. Quick little status update. I want to try to get weekly reviews out to you guys, but they might not be as crazy intellectually deep as the Iron Manathon in this one, because I've been trying to put stupid messages in my toy reviews to try to better the people who watch my videos, which I'll probably do commentary tracks or like just like explanation videos to tell you what my point is. But yeah, definitely try to pick this figure up, and please, if you like this content, this kind of content, please like, comment, subscribe. I'm gonna try to get toy reviews out on this channel weekly during the summer. But if I miss a week, I'm sorry. I'll try to get as many reviews out as I can. And if I miss a week, I'll probably let you know why in the next toy review. But yeah, I'll see you all in the next video, which will probably be another toy review. Like, comment, subscribe, click the doobly-doos, and I will see you in the next toy review, which might be a Transformer. Who knows? Bye-bye.